Welcome to the segment in our series on using CSS media queries to create a mobile-first responsive design. Now we are ready to explore approaches for organizing your mobile-first responsive design CSS. So far, we placed all our CSS and the media queries into one HTML document. You might say we should use the HTML link tag to load external CSS files. You would point out, this is how we share CSS across multiple HTML documents. And you are right. The approach we will demonstrate uses multiple separate CSS files. One file will contain the base CSS and one file for each targeted screen width. But do we still need the media query selectors? Media query selectors are just CSS. They will work the same in external CSS files. However, the HTML link tag has a media attribute. Conveniently, it uses the same media query syntax as the CSS media selector. This is how we are going to do our example. Now, this is just one approach. You need to consider other possible approaches. So we also sketch out organizational alternatives, then investigate the performance criteria that is involved. We are starting with the completed practice file from the last video. We also have empty versions of the CSS files ready to go. First, open the practice file in Firefox, then activate the Firefox responsive view. Now we can do a quick review of the current width breakpoints. This is the base CSS. The first width breakpoint was at 320 pixels. Remember, we were applying simple styling changes that included font sizes, padding, margins, and background colors. The second width breakpoint was at 768 pixels. The last screen width breakpoint was at 1024 pixels. This breakpoint included one layout change to prevent the text from unwrapping at 1200 pixels. Let's start by refactoring the document CSS into the base CSS file. We have the base selectors in the practice HTML file on lines 8 through 37. We will cut them, then paste them on line 2 of the base CSS file. We can remove the line indents. Now we can attach the base CSS file to the practice file using the HTML link element. In the snippets.txt file, lines 91 to 92 have both an accompanying HTML comment and the HTML link line of code. Copy those lines. In the practice file, paste them on line 7. Save all files. Now we can check everything in Firefox, the base CSS, the 320 width breakpoint, the 768 width breakpoint, the 1024 width breakpoint. Nothing has changed as we expected. Still, let's view the source to be sure we tested the correct code. There is the changed source. Now we will move the 320 media query selectors to their own CSS file. Cut lines 14 to 30 in the practice file. Notice we are not taking the CSS media selector or its block curly braces. We're moving them to the CSS file named screen-min-320.css. Paste and unindent flush with the left margin. We could have included the entire CSS media selector block, but we did not because the CSS in the file is dedicated to the same width target. That allows us to use the HTML link tag media attribute to select the entire file. Now we can attach this CSS file to the practice file. We have the tags ready in the snippets file on lines 95 and 96. Paste them on line 9 of the practice file. At this point, the 320 pixel CSS file will override the base CSS file for any matching selectors and properties. That may seem what we want at first glance. That is until you realize that we repeat this for the next two breakpoints. Once we do that, the last attached CSS file will predominate at every width breakpoint. To prevent this, we add media queries to the link tags media attribute. Let's type that in before the href attribute. The value is already done on line 15. Copy just the media query. You do not want the media selector or the block open curly brace. Then paste that inside the double quotes for the media attribute on line 9. Now the media selector and the curly braces on lines 12 to 16 are not needed and can be removed. Save all files. Reload and check the source. Firefox Source View will show any syntax errors in case you are having problems. Also, we can be sure we have the right version. Now we can run all our tests at the target breakpoints, 320, 768, 1024. Now repeat this for the 768 width media query. Cut lines 15 to 26 in the practice file. Paste in the screen-min-768 CSS file. Indent to the left margin. Copy lines 99 and 100 from the snippets file. Paste on line 11 of the practice file. Type in the media attribute with an empty value. Copy the media query part of line 16. Remember, omit the media selector and curly brace. Paste that in as the media attribute value on line 12. Then delete lines 14 to 17. Save all files. Check that the code we changed is in the source that we are testing. Run your test again, 320, 768, 1024. We just have the 1024 breakpoint media query remaining to finish our refactoring work. Copy lines 17 to 26 in the practice file. Paste an indent to the left margin in the screen-min-1024 CSS file. Copy the link tag from lines 103 and 104 of the snippets file. Paste those on line 13. Add the shell for the media attribute on line 14. Copy the media query from line 18. Paste that to finish the media attribute on line 14. Now we can remove the entire style tag from the practice file. Save your files and run the tests again. Verify the code version we are testing first, the practice document, the base CSS, the 320 width CSS, the 768 width CSS, and the 1024 width CSS. All are loaded and without errors. Our final test starts with the 1024 width. There is the layout constraint on text wrapping. Now at 768, then 320, finally the base. This approach can work well for you. It reduces the length of CSS and organizes the targets into separate files. But by adding 4 CSS files, we have also exposed 4 HTTP network requests. Network requests can provide overhead that could impact timing. For lightweight traffic requirements, this should not be significant. If it is a problem, consider some alternatives. The obvious approach is to use one external CSS file. In that approach, place the same CSS we had in the style tag into that file. Another approach is to have 2 CSS files, one for the base and one for the screen width changes. Then attach this after the base CSS file, without the HTML link tag media attribute. The media selectors in the file will do the detections. In the beginning of our series, we learned about other media query tests. For example, we could test for screen resolution or orientation. Your design requirements increase when targeting particular design features. This can result in more media queries for the same target minimum widths. In that case, you may consider our approach in the example we completed. The first CSS file is for smartphone widths, the second for tablet widths, the last for laptops and desktops. Each represents the base CSS for that target minimum width. Then within that target minimum width group, you can add additional media queries targeting special cases, such as a different pixel density image for a Retina device versus a legacy device. You just add CSS media selectors within the CSS file for those special circumstances. There is a lot to think about in organizing your media queries. You could end up with a spaghetti of media queries. The mobile-first approach using minimum widths is one way to avoid that.